Yes, hello there. I'm just hailing with the Armageddon report, isn't it? No, it's not. I don't know. So, is there some actual Armageddon going to happen? Probably not. But there's a slight chance on tomorrow and the day thereafter. But today, fairly tame. Only a 5% chance of winds and hail, and apparently no real chance of a tornado. Let's play guess the name of all the states, right? So here is the wind map. So we've got Washington, Oregon, Nevada, Potato State, also known as Idaho, right, Montana, North Dakota, South Dakota, and Wyoming. I know all the names of these states because I cheated and looked before. See, my job would be so much easier if they'd actually put the names of the states on these maps. Anyway, hail map. There is some chances of it. So it's basically, appears to be this map, only, let's see, a little bit more east and then completely disconnected there, of course. So that's what's going on with the hail probability map. 5%, 2% chance. Less than 2% is what I meant to say. Anyway, if you're not familiar with what the 5% means, so if we pick any random area, a point within any of these random 5% areas, that means there's a 5% chance that that point or someone within 25 miles of them will see whatever that event is. So in this case, hail, in this case, wind. So still, it's fairly low that you personally would be affected, especially if you're not in one of those areas. Then it's a pretty good, there's a pretty good likelihood you won't be affected at all. Tomorrow, though, we've got a slight risk again. This is the first one in days. I have no idea. Half week? Surely hasn't been a whole week. It is spring. There's stuff going on. Anyway, so what have we got? If we read it off here, though, we know Iowa, Illinois, Indiana, Kentucky, a little bit of Ohio, maybe a little bit of Tennessee, maybe a bit of Missouri. I don't know. So here's the probability map where you can see Pacific Northwest again with the 5% chance, and then it goes even more. You know, the 5% chance, it goes more north, it goes every direction. It expands outward from the 15% chance, as it often does. Day after tomorrow. Stuff may be going on. What we've got a smidge of Wyoming again. Nebraska, Kansas, Colorado's in the slight risk. And then we pop on over to this map where we can see that it's got a huge tail. It's like a comet or something. It's dragging a 5% area behind it. Or it's like the wedding dress thing where there's, what do they call that? The train? The wedding dress train. Someone's standing back here holding it up and it's booking west. That would be how, you know, because otherwise the bride would be going the wrong direction. But nothing really travels west, does it? Not in this hemisphere. So, yes, 5% chance for quite a few states day after tomorrow, but still, again, fairly low. Now, if that were like 45%, that would be news, because that would be huge, or maybe not. I don't know. So, day 438, again, nothing indicated on the map, but again, the words predictability too low instead of probability too low, meaning that there is severe weather indicated in the medium range models, but there's not enough agreement between them or whatever, run to run, whatever is the terminology that they use, to indicate there's not enough certainty to actually put something on the map. So yes, today here is where you should pay attention. Right, WickedWix, WICKEDWX.com. Righto, or National Weather Service Storm Prediction Center, you know, you go hang out and you're like, what's going on with this? And I don't know. Anyway, so enjoy whatever today is. Is it tisdag? I'm trying to learn Swedish, but apparently not very good. Goodly. Mert, I think it might be that in Irish. Mert, it's like the word for March, only it's similar. I don't know. Anyway, also known as Tuesday, right? Anyway, enjoy it. Right.